Welcome to prefabricated structures. So in this video we will be seeing related to the prefabricated brick panel and partially precast concrete joist for flooring and roofing specification. This standard lays down requirement for prefabricated brick panel and partially precast joist for flooring and roofing. So this particular figure shows us the brick panel, how it has been prepared in terms for the flooring or roofing. And here we are able to see the precast concrete joists are used for the supporting of flooring or roofing. Here these are the materials: concrete, reinforcement, bricks. So these materials are used for the particular prefabricated brick panels. Concrete used for making prefabricated brick panels and joist shall conform to the grade of M15 of IS 456-1978. Coarse aggregate used for making concrete shall be well graded with maximum size of 12 mm for brick panels and well graded with maximum size of 20 mm for joist. Reinforcement. The reinforcement steel is recommended as IS 456-1978 shall be used. So whatever the recommendations are as per the IS 456 for reinforcement in the concrete, the same part has to be used in this particular construction of the prefabricated also. Bricks used for making prefabricated panels shall conform to IS 1077, IS 12894, IS 313757. Bricks of higher strength are also to be conformed to Indian standard 2180, may also be under use. So these are the particular part of the bricks which we have to use in the materials. Then coming dimensions and tolerances. So what are the dimensions and tolerances which are divided for the two parts: prefabricated brick panel and partially precast joist. So here in this figure we can see a prefabricated brick panel is being lifted, and the two people where they are standing, it is being going to be fixed at this particular position. So here we can see this as the precasted, but once we see it, it is being constructed like that, we are able to see, but it is precasted. So prefabricated brick panel, length of a panel shall not exceed 1.1 meter for bricks having strength less than 40 newton per mm square. For our bricks having strength more than 40 newton per mm square, conforming to Indian standard 2180, the length of panel shall not exceed 1.2 meters. From the economy point of view, the minimum recommended length of the panel is 0.9 meters. Thickness of transverse joist may be varied within the range specified in 4.3.2 of the IS 14143 for varying the length. Now, in the width part for prefabricated panel, what is the width of this particular part? So width of the panel shall be of 53 centimeter panels made up of conventional size 230 mm by 110 mm by 75 mm. So 230 mm length and width in 110 mm, and thickness is 75 mm. So bricks and 45 mm centimeter for panels made for modular size of 190 mm by 90 mm by 90 mm under the bricks are considered. Thickness of the panel shall be equal to thickness of brick, that is 75 mm for conventional size of brick and 90 mm for modular size of bricks. So this is 75 mm for conventional size, 90 mm for modular bricks. So here we can see the brick panel is served as the roofing material or as a flooring material for the upper level. So wherever the concrete is not available, this type of brick panels are prepared and then they are laid over the joist such that these becomes as the prefabricated brick panels. So this is the one of the isometric view of prefab brick panel, how this is been prepared. So a length of a brick and a breadth of a brick, and then there is a reinforcement is provided such as two numbers of 6 mm diameter in each panel. The particular concreting is done. This is the total length, and size of a broken brick bat vary as per the length of panel. So this joint is provided in the terms of opening. So in between whatever the mortar filling, the concrete filling is there, it varies from 15 mm to 30 mm, and at the edge, whatever the concrete is holding the reinforcement, it is having minimum of 50 mm, not greater than 50 mm or not less than 50 mm. Number of bricks to be adjusted, keeping width as 15 to 30 mm. So this is the width, we have to keep it as 15 to 30 mm. Number of bricks, how many can be accommodated, we can easily see in this particular figure. So this is the total length of the panel and this is the total breadth of the panel, wherein the breadth of the panel consists of breadth of the brick, two times breadth of the brick and length of the brick, and two times the thickness is provided for the mortar joint in between. So height is again have to consider. So minimum strength of concrete should be M15 grade. So M15 grade is the minimum strength of the concrete which has to be used in this particular constructions. Partially precast joist shape. So how is this partially precast joist? So here we can see these are the joist, and above there are these are the partially, and then the cement concreting is laid and the final finishing of the cement concreting is prepared in this way. So this is the prepared first earlier, and this is after the laying is done and the joints are filled. So shall be rectangular in shape with a steel stirrup keeping projecting out, which shall be tied with the reinforcement along the joist to achieve monolithically with concrete. So here these are joined and this is the particular connections is done. Width of partially precast shall be sufficient to support two successive span of brick panels with sufficient bearing leveling and adequate gap between them. The minimum width is 13 cm, which may be increased if required for structural strength. Depth. The recommended depth for precast joist for clean span of joist up to 4.2 meters shall be 100 mm for both conventional and modular size bricks. Accordingly, overall depth of joist in width C2 concrete of 35 mm shall be 210 mm for conventional bricks and 225 mm for modular bricks. So here is the typical partially prefabricated joist. So this is the particular prefabricated joist which we are able to see, 4500 mm max and 130 mm minimum. So length we can take. So these are the reinforcements which are provided into the precast joist, which can easily be lifted and they gets as connections in the monolithic connections. So this is the cross section. If we are able to see in this from this side, we can see this part of the cross section, 130 mm in the width wise and stirrups as per the design. So 6 mm stirrups at 135 mm center to center, diameter is 6 mm in diameter. The height is minimum 100 mm up to 4200 mm clear span, and height is 125 minimum up to 4200 mm clear span. So 100 mm is minimum, maximum is we can go up to 125 mm, or minimum also we can go up to 125 mm, as maximum we can take it as 130 mm as a square section itself. Design criteria. What are the design criteria for prefabricated brick panels? There are three stages: precasting, lifting, transporting and handling. First stage, placing and accidental loading during construction is the second stage. Final loading condition is the third stage. So we can see that particular part of things. The following load shall be considered for different stages of design. For stage 1, self weight of the panel without in situ concrete plus 50%. without in situ concrete plus 50% of self weight of panel for impact or vibration during handling and transporting. For stage 2, self weight of panel including the self weight of in situ concrete and in accidental load, which in absence of more accurate information may be taken as per half the imposed load given in stage 3. Stage 3 is self weight of a panel including in situ concrete and imposed load as specified in IS 875 part 2, the loading pattern, and the load of 200 kg per meter square or 100 kg per meter square for roofs or floors respectively are to be considered for the design criteria of the prefabricated brick panels. Precasted partially joist. So here also three stages are there: placing, lifting, transporting and handling comes under stage 1, placing and accidental loading during construction stage 2, final loading condition is stage 3. Stage 1, same weight of joist plus 50% self weight of a joist for impact or vibration during handling and transportation. Stage 2, joist shall be propped at two points, one and a one-third span of before laying brick panels and one-third, that is L3 span, shall be taken for length, design purpose and safe self weight of joist and panel including in situ concrete and accidental load, which in the absence of more accurate part of the information may be taken as a half the imposed load given for stage 2. Stage 3, self weight of a joist, dead load and brick panel including in situ concrete imposed load in accordance with IS 875 for the loading of floor or it may be roof. So these are the precast partially joist. The partially joist precast shall be designed as a T-beam. Why we need to design it as a T-beam? Because it takes a load as terms of slab and the beam. So that's why it comes for the T-beam part with 35 mm flange. For stage 3 of loading and as partially precast beam for stage 1 and stage 2 of loading. Reinforcement required with normal loading for various spans of joist for spacing of 1200 mm center to center as per the table from IS 14142 1994 for steel reinforcement various spans for joist for spacing up to 1200 center to center. So these are the reinforcements which has to be provided and this is the clear span of the joist. So span varies from 1800 mm to 4200 mm. In between these are the reinforcements which are to be provided. So we can say that the stirrups till 3900 130 mm center to center we can provide. Whereas for four numbers of 6 mm diameter center to center are to be provided for the 4200 mm length. And bottom reinforcements are separate for every part. Middle reinforcements are same up to 2700. Then it changes to 8 mm for 3600. For 3900 and 400, it goes to 10 number diameter. Top again 6 up to the all the sections similar, but only bottom, middle, and some stirrups are going to change in the precast partially joist. So this is one of the prefabricated brick panels. When we see from the cross sections, the two beams are provided and it is provided. So now we can see that brick panel and prefabricated partially joist comes into account when both are used as a connectivity. So here this is the precast joist and this is the precast brick panel. So brick panel is here which is being rested over the precast joist, by which a monolithic construction can be provided and both the materials are used for the roofing panel or for the flooring panel of the upper stories. So here we can able to understand what is the joist. It is a beam. And what is the brick panels? It is a floor or a roof type of construction which we are using for the preparation of prefabricated roof or floor structures. So these are the some of the figures wherein we are able to see this is the brick panel which can be prepared. So from olden days they are been preparing under the brick panels. So bricks are laid and above the concreting is prepared. Then they are just grooving the particular part where it is be taken, and then the it is separated as this. So this is the one of the brick panels. We are able to see the bricks of orange brown color, and cement is mortar. Person is standing such that these each panels are prepared. Also these panels are converted in terms of newer way, this RCC panels wherein the reinforcement is provided, and the particular thing what the cement mortar can be placed into these particular sections. So this is the joist which is prepared for the carrying loading, that is beam type. So here is one joist and on the other end is there is joist. So these are the particular length of the roofing panels or the brick panels wherein the construction goes. These acts as the roof panel or as the floor panels. And thank you. See you in the next video.